Fuel is being pumped into a storage tank. The volume V of the fuel in the tank depends on the depth d according to the formula. V of d is equal to 4 times 3d squared plus 5 to the third power, where d is measured in meters. Suppose that the depth d of the fuel depends on time, measured in hours according to the formula. D of t is equal to 1 over the square root of 3 times the square root of t minus 5. And that makes sense, that if I'm pumping something into a storage tank, the depth of the fuel is going to depend on time, and then the volume could be dependent on the depth. Use function composition to write the volume of the fuel in the tank as a function of time. Simplify your answer as much as possible. So let me get my scratch pad out. So I've already written what they told us here. This is volume as a function of depth. And now this is depth as a function of time. So if we want volume as a function of time, what we really want to do is figure out what is, so we could take V of d, we could say V of d of t, V of d of t, d of t. Now this will give me volume as a function of time. So everywhere where I see a d, I should replace it with this description. I should replace it with this description of how does d vary with respect to time. So let's do that. So v of d of t is going to be equal to 4 times 3 times d squared. But instead of writing d squared, I'm going to write all of this business squared. So 1 over square root of 3 times the square root of t minus 5, all of that squared, plus 5 to the third power. I really hope this simplifies in a reasonable way. So let's see. Let me actually copy and paste this so I can have a little bit more real estate. So let me just paste it down here so I can work it out. All right. So then we get this is going to be equal to, this is going to be equal to, let's see, if we square this right over here, and I could do it all in, so this is going to be 4 times 3 times this whole thing squared. So this whole thing squared, 1 over square root of 3 squared is going to be 1/3, and then square root of t minus 5 squared is going to be t minus 5, and then of course we have plus 5, to the third power. Let's see, 3 times 1/3, well that's just going to be equal to 1. And so we are left with, this is equal to 4 times t minus 5 plus 5. This does simplify nicely. Plus 5. So we're going to be left with 4 times t to the third power. 4 times t to the third power. So let's input that into our. And so v of t, and let me just make it clear. This is giving our volume as a function of time. We can now say that this is v of t. V of t is 4t squared. Once again, this is the volume as a function of time. You give me a time, I'll tell you what the volume is. So 4t to the third. 4t to the third power. V of t, did I say 4t squared? I don't know, sometimes I do strange things. I said 4t to the third power. 4t to the third power, and it did format it correctly. And then there's a second part of this question. How many cubic meters of fuel are in the tank after 2 hours? Round your answer to the nearest tenth. Well, 2 hours, that means t is equal to 2. They say t is measured in hours. So when t is equal to 2, the volume is going to be, so 2 to the third power is 8. 8 times 4 is 32. 32. And let's check our answer, and we got it right.